Good asset management is essential to delivering sustainable service to customers with low cost and low risk. In order to facilitate better asset management, mWater has developed asset system features, which you can now freely use to map and monitor water systems anywhere in the world and at any scale. In this video, we'll cover how asset systems work in mWater and how you can get started making use of them. Here are some key features of asset systems in mWater. It's easy to use. You can just sign up to mWater for free, get the Surveyor app, and start mapping your system right away. It's comprehensive. You can log all types of water supply infrastructure with all kinds of asset types and data fields provided for you. You get to choose how much of that you fill in. Asset systems are flexible in that when you are mapping your water system, you can organize the assets in a hierarchy that works best for you and your workflow. It's also scalable, where you can freely track any number of assets from individual boreholes to citywide utilities. And asset systems are actionable in mWater, thanks to mWater's existing extensive data analytics features. You can build dashboards and reports that highlight the data you need to see to help you prioritize your work and actually do asset management better. Here's an illustration of the scalability of asset systems in mWater, where you can start with individual boreholes and maybe connected assets such as tanks, power supplies, pipes, treatment units. You can map entire rural water supply systems or small towns with main pipelines, service pipes, and lots of components. Or you can scale up and map entire large urban utilities, all leveraging the scalability of mWater, having that data on a shared server where you control the data and who sees it, but don't have to worry about running your own server or your own system. The asset systems in mWater are based on the Water System Management Standard, which you can access in the video notes, which splits assets into various classes and types. It covers the whole range of what can be tracked within a water system. And each of these asset types comes with sets of data fields adhering to the Water System Management Standard that you can fill in, so you know you're accessing something comprehensive with thought-through answers and options that fit your use case. So let's take a look at an example of an electrical asset type. So here in a simple system, in the app side, you can see basic properties that have been filled in for this transformer. Where it is, what's the status and condition, financial information about the current replacement cost and expected useful life, some technical information like when it was installed, who by, and funded by, and any other information, much more. And for each different asset type, these fields are tailored to the needs of that. Here on the right side, we see what this asset looks like in the mWater portal when you're looking at the asset system as a whole. So let's jump in and look at how you could start mapping a water system. Once you've logged in, you can see there's a water assets option on the home page. You can select that and immediately start adding a water system by creating a root asset, which is either the water system or for individual wells such as boreholes with components you want to map, you could choose water point as well. We'll choose a water system, and then all you need to do is fill in the fields that you want to track for that water system. So let's say I'm doing it just privately for my test here. Give it a name, maybe describe it, take a photo. You can use the phone GPS or a map to set the location of your system. and then fill in other fields such as the urban-rural classification, overall status, yes, it's an active system, overall it's in good condition, and it is a distribution network with a pumped supply. High-level things like that at the system level. Once you click Create, this system is there, and as soon as your app syncs with the mWater server, it's going to exist visible on the portal as well. Now that you've created the system, we can start creating its children. So all the assets that belong within this water system, within this root asset. So to work through a couple of examples, we could add another asset such as the water source. Give it an asset ID maybe if we want. Again, put a location to it. Let's say our source is here. It is active and in excellent condition. We can add some things like the installation date, which is important if we want to track the age of things, when it was last serviced, what kind of source is it, a borehole, what's the flow, well depth, things such as this. All these options are offered on the basis of the water system management standard, but none of them are marked as required. So you can go into that level of detail that actually helps you with your asset management. So now we've created a water source. Then we can start choosing how we structure our overall system, because we can select the water source within our water system and add a child to that. So perhaps we would want to have our pump as part of the source, for example. And create a pump ID, pump asset. Set its location where the source is. And again, go through this process of filling in the technical details that make sense. Just going through this quickly for example's sake. We can jump back up to the water system level, we've got our water source, and I'll show you also how to draw a pipe. So the app allows you to not just capture point data, but also draw pipes by editing a line. You can walk along this line in the field, or you can add points here in the app or in the portal. If I happen to know that the pipe goes like so to this household connection, let's say, I can draw it or walk along it. And so I've created a pipe. And again, there are other details I can fill in. And then under the pipe, if I want to, I could create a tap, a water point. Identify the customer somehow, place it in the right location, and so on. A piped connection to a residential area. Great. So now we've gone through a few steps of starting to map our system, and there'll be a separate video with a more detailed how to do this. This is just giving you a sense of how easy it can be to start mapping your water system. Now, once we've done that and synced the app, it sends this data to the server and you can start viewing it in the mWater portal at portal.mwater.co. Here we can jump over to manage assets and see if we can find the system we created, and then look at a more comprehensive one in more detail. So this was created a little island around about here. And we can see that what we just created in the app is now also visible here in the portal, where you can see the hierarchy, navigate that, and see these details. It's also important to note that any data that you've collected and have access to in these water systems is available to you when you're building maps, dashboards, or consoles right here in the mWater portal. So you can build interactive visualizations that show the data you want to show, highlight the things you want to highlight, and we'll take a little bit of a look at that. There'll be another video going more into depth on how to visualize and analyze your asset data. So that's the system we created, where we can see that there are many ways to structure your water system. Here in this large Dakai water system, there are different facilities that contain different areas of this large system. For example, a whole area for distribution, another one for treatment, third one for production, and so on. The different boreholes and pumps and all their components. So you can choose how to structure this hierarchy in a way that makes most sense to you and the level of detail of the types of assets you find worth tracking. That flexibility is fundamentally there. So that's a quick view of how assets work in the app and the portal. And you can also build dashboards such as this one, where you choose what you show on the map, what layers are there, how it's colored, what shows up in tables, calculate certain values such as the age from the installation, and zoom in on the key information you want to zoom in. And then, knowing that these visualizations are interactive, you can filter on one widget and see the other widgets update accordingly. If you wanted to look at power infrastructure, you can. If you want to zoom in on all the troublesome spots where things aren't functional, you can do that too and find boreholes that are not working and address these issues. And this is just a simple example. You can build entire consoles with many tabs, a whole control center where you can highlight the things that make sense to highlight. So that's an overview of asset systems in mWater, which we've tried to design to be easy to use, comprehensive by catering for all kinds of asset types, flexible so that you can adjust them to fit your needs at any scale, and then look at the data you've collected in a way that's actionable and highlights key things that you want to see. So feel free to get started. Use the system for free at any scale. Start mapping your water systems. If you've got any feedback, get in touch with us at info@mwater.co. And be sure to look at our other guidance for more in-depth information on the asset types, as well as how-tos on the visualization and data collection side. Thanks very much for watching, and have a great day.